Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. We welcome those that may be watching by internet or may watch this later on archive. Tonight we'll be studying and preaching out of the book of Joshua, chapter 10, starting in verse 1. And when you have it, you can either stand or just say amen so I know everybody is ready. And it reads, "Now it came to pass, when Adonizek, king of Jerusalem, had heard how Joshua had taken Ai and had utterly destroyed it, as he had done to Jericho and her king, so he had done to Ai and her king, and how the inhabitants of Gibeon had made peace with Israel and were among them, that they feared greatly because Gibeon was a great city as one of the royal cities, and because it was greater than Ai, and all the men thereof were mighty. Wherefore Adonizek, king of Jerusalem, sent unto Honam, king of Hebron, and unto Piram, king of Jarmuth, and unto Japhai, king of Lachish, and unto Debir, king of Eglon, saying, Come up unto me and help me, that we may smite Gibeon, for it has made peace with Joshua and with the children of Israel. Therefore the five kings of the Amorites, the king of Jerusalem, the king of Hebron, the king of Jarmuth, and the king of Lachish, and the king of Eglon, gathered themselves together and went up, they and all their host, and encamped before Gibeon, and made war against it." And we'll stop right there. The day the sun stood still. I said, the day the sun stood still. Heavenly Father, Lord, we love you, and Lord, we thank you for the opportunity to come once again in your house and worship you and hear your word, Lord. Father, I ask in the name of Jesus, Lord, that you soften hearts, Lord. Open up their spiritual eyes and ears and hearts, Lord, and let them receive this message with gladness and with joy, and let it edify them, Lord, and let it give them revelation of what Jesus did at Calvary. And Lord, we give you all the praise, we give you all the glory in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. And you may be seated. Praise God. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah, church. Praise the Lord. Joshua here in this book is a type of our heavenly Joshua. Amen. And really the name Joshua in English is translated to Jesus. And in the Greek it's translated to Joshua. And in the Hebrew it's translated to Yeshua. Amen. So here this is a type and shadow of Jesus Christ, the man Joshua here in the Old Testament. Amen. Type of a man who walked by faith and grace. Amen. And just as I ministered this morning against sin and what it can do to a person, now tonight, amen, I'm going to start in part two on how you can, once you give your heart and life to Christ and you make peace with Joshua, the enemy will come against you with all it's got, amen. But you can have victory. I said you can have victory. Hallelujah, church. I don't think you're getting that tonight. I said you can have victory tonight, church. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. And we see here, just like it was with Gibeon, it's the same way for every person who comes to Jesus Christ and makes peace with God. The enemy does not like it. And the confederation here of these five kings of Amorites is a type and shadow of the powers of darkness. Amen. And when they heard that Gibeon had made peace with Joshua and the children of Israel, they got upset and they feared and they got worried. And they said, we need to take Gibeon out. Amen. When you gave your heart and life to Christ, Satan and all the powers of darkness did not like it. And they all came together and they plotted your death and they had plotted your destruction and said, we have to take you out. The Bible says in Ephesians 6:12, we don't wrestle against flesh and blood, but we wrestle against principalities and powers. Amen. And let me tell you, when you gave your heart and life to Christ, those powers of darkness came together and plotted against you. I said, they plotted against you. Oh, you don't you know you are a threat to the kingdom of darkness the minute you get saved? Amen. In Ephesians 6:12, we see the kingdom of darkness. It says the first one is principalities, which are rulers or beings of the highest rank and order in Satan's kingdom. After that rank, there's a rank against which is called powers, the rank immediately below principalities. Against, and then the next rank is against the rulers of darkness, amen, which are right under below the rank of powers. And of course, then the final lowest rank is spiritual wickedness in high places, amen. So just as we have rankings in the physical military, guess what? In the spiritual military, there are rankings as well. Amen. I said there are rankings as well. In the kingdom of God, there are rankings. There's the archangels, there's angels, there's cherubims. Amen. And in the army of God, there's preachers, there's intercessory prayer warriors, there's the ministry of helps. Amen. People who work in the gifts of the Spirit, and also in the powers of darkness, there's rankings as well. And we see that here in Ephesians 6:12. Amen. There are principalities, powers, rulers of darkness, and spiritual wickedness in high places. And all five of those rankings come together and say, we need to take this man or woman of God out. Amen. And just as the Amorites Confederate a legion came together and said, we need to take Gibeon out. That's what Satan and all the powers of darkness have said about you. Amen. And what they do is they'll come full force at you. They will oppress you. They will tempt you. Amen. Trying to draw you away from the Lord with worldly lusts, with pleasures of sin, with bondage, so that they may make strongholds in your heart. Amen. And here we see when Satan does do that and comes at you, we see here in this story of when the sun stood still of what the answer is. First of all, I want to point out here in verse 6, it says, and the men of Gibeon sent on to Joshua to the camp of Gilgal. The first thing you should do is not turn to self, should not turn to psychology, should not turn to activity, should not turn to seminars, should not turn to self-help programs, but we need to turn to our heavenly Joshua, because he's the only one who holds the answer for you and me. And Gibeon did the exact right thing that they should have. And that's exactly what the believer needs to do when the enemy comes against us. When all the powers of darkness cohort together, plot your despise, and come at you with full force. The first thing we should do is call on the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Not calling on man, not calling on programs, not calling on self-helps, but calling on the Lord himself. Not Muhammad, not Buddha, not Confucius, but Jesus Christ, King of Kings and Lord of Lords. The church needs to get back to that. I said the church needs to get back to that. Amen. Throw away everything else. Amen. We need to have a bonfire and throw out all the false doctrine and just call on our heavenly Joshua once again. Because that is the only thing that guarantees help. I said, that's the only thing that guarantees help is calling on the Lord. Amen. You can call on me. Amen. There's only so much I can do. I can't help you. Amen. All I can do is point you to the person who can. Amen. That's what I'm doing here tonight. Amen. I don't have your answers. Amen. I can take a little sweat and sell it for $29.95. I can get a bottle of water here if you want. We can sell it for $9.99, but it ain't going to do you no good. May wet your lips a little bit, but I don't have the answer. Amen. I don't hold it, but I know who does. His name is Jesus Christ, King of Kings and Lord of Lords. And He's the only one that can help you. Whatever you're struggling with, whatever bondage Satan has tried to put you in, just call out to the Lord, and He is faithful to answer. Hallelujah. It's that simple, church. The religious world has made it too hard, amen. You have to take 3 years of catechism. You have to take programs. You have to go through classes. No, you don't. The Bible makes it easy. Faith and grace. Father, in the name of Jesus, help me. Amen. I heard a testimony of a man, amen, who was on alcohol and drugs, and he didn't know what to do, amen. And he turned on SBN for the first time, amen. And he started hearing the message of the cross being preached. He didn't know what to do. It wasn't the prettiest prayer, but it got her done. He laid his hand on the TV when they did the sinner's prayer, and he prayed the only thing he knew. Now I lay me down to sleep. I pray the Lord to the soul to keep. If I die before I wake, oh, hallelujah. Saved by grace. Praise God. You can have victory tonight over the world, the flesh, and the devil. Hallelujah. All you got to do is call on your heavenly Joshua, Jesus Christ, a man who came out of Nazareth. Amen. Born in a manger in Bethlehem. Hallelujah. There was nothing beautiful about him on the inside, but oh, praise God, he can do wonders on the inside. Amen. Hallelujah. And that's exactly what Gibeon did in this event. They called on Joshua. They didn't try to do it themselves. They didn't try to use technology. They didn't try to use their intellectualism, try to outmaneuver the enemy. They just went straight to Joshua. That's what believers need to do. You just go straight to Jesus. Amen. I don't care what the problem is, whether it's lust, whether it's family issues, whether it's things in the heart. I don't care what it is. Just go straight to Jesus. Hallelujah. I said go straight to Jesus. Don't go to a denomination. Amen. They don't hold your answer. Amen. Don't go to a certain pastor because he can't do it for you. But you go straight to Jesus Christ Himself. Amen. Don't you know you can go boldly into the throne room of grace in His name and ask whatever it is you need of. Hallelujah. Man will let you down, but Christ never will. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Go straight to your heavenly Joshua. I said, go straight to your heavenly Joshua. Hallelujah. And that's what Gibeon did. Amen. And when they did, we see what happens here in the next few verses in verse 10. It says, and the Lord discomfited them before Israel and slew them with a great slaughter at Gibeon and chased them along the way that goes up to Bethron and smote them to Azekah and onto Makkedah. And it came to pass as they fled from before Israel and were in the going down to Bethoron that the Lord cast down great stones from heaven upon them onto Hezekiah. And they died. And they were more which died with hailstones than they whom the children of Israel slew with the sword. Amen. Well, what's that have to do with anything, Brother Brett? The whole power of God, the Holy Spirit, is opened up to you. Hallelujah. You get the help of the Holy Spirit the minute you say in the name of Jesus. I said, I mean, when you first say in the name of Jesus, amen, when you're praying to the Father and cry out to the Lord in His Son's name, guess what? You just opened up the door for the help of the Holy Spirit to work wonders in your life. There ain't nothing that the Holy Spirit can't do. Hallelujah. He is God Almighty. He's all-knowing. He's all-powerful, He's all-wise, and He's everywhere. Amen. Doesn't matter where you are. If you call on your heavenly Joshua, you are guaranteed. You can take that to the bank and cash it. Hallelujah. You are guaranteed the help of the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. That verse 10 says, it doesn't say, and the philosophers discomforted them. Amen. It doesn't say, and they were sorely afraid of the self-help programs. Amen. It says, and the Lord discomforted them. Amen. The minute you call on the name of the Lord, the Holy Spirit goes to work. Amen. It starts discomforting. Amen. That power or that sin that is a stronghold in your life and in your heart. Amen. Guarantees. That's how the Holy Spirit operates. Amen. It's through Christ Jesus and only Him that no flesh should be glorified except Christ. Amen. For the law of the Spirit of life in Christ Jesus has made me free from the law of sin and death. You want the help of the Holy Spirit? Call on the name of Jesus Christ, your heavenly Joshua. Hallelujah. And when we go His direction and His way, amen, we have the help and the power of the Holy Spirit. Amen. To get us out of whatever predicament, whatever bondage, whatever stronghold that is in our life. Amen. And He can do wonders. I said He can do wonders. I said He can do wonders. I said He can do wonders. Amen. He can do anything. Amen. He's taken alcohol out of my life. Amen. He's taken cigarettes out of my life. Amen. He's taken bondages out of my life. Amen. He's given me victory over them. Hallelujah. He can do anything. Praise God. If you could go back in time when I was 17, 18, 19, 20 years old in college, if you could see, amen, if you only knew the sins I was in, amen, and seeing me today, what the Holy Spirit has done through Christ, because of Christ, amen, I should put it that way. That's a miracle. I said, it's a miracle. I said, it's a miracle, church. I don't think you understand. Think back in your life of everything, the depths of sin that you went into. Hallelujah. And how the Holy Spirit, because of what Christ has done, had pulled you out. His power pulled you out and changed you, molded you, delivered you, healed you. Hallelujah. There ain't nothing the Holy Spirit can't do. Praise God. I remember Brother Swaggart, amen, he was talking about a man who was in World War II and he was in a foxhole, amen, and it was night and the Germans ambushed, amen, and the German had the bayonet and he was just about ready to put it into the American soldier, and the American soldier cried out, he said, Jesus help me, and the German froze right there, amen, and in broken English he said, you know Jesus? And the man said, yes, I do. He put up his gun, he says, my mother was a Christian. Put down his gun, amen, took out the first aid kit and wrapped his wounded where he got shot in that foxhole, amen, and the German went off on his way because he called on the name of the Lord, and the Holy Spirit can do anything. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Praise the Lord. I said, praise the Lord. Jesus guarantees the help of the Holy Spirit because of what He's already done. Amen. He's taken away sin. Amen. The veil's been ripped. Amen. There was a spiritual veil in your heart, amen, that kept you between God and you, amen. And that veil was sin. But when Christ died, amen, at the cross, amen, and you accepted Christ, that veil was torn and ripped, and now you have the power and you have the presence of the Holy Spirit to go to work in your life, amen. And you can have as much of Him as you want. Amen. He'll stay in your heart. He'll abode in your heart. And if you ask Him to, He will fill you with power. He will give you victory over sin because it's been paid for. Amen. Well, what do I have to do, Brother Brad, to get it? Just call on His name and He'll give it to you. Hallelujah. Doesn't matter whether it's salvation. Doesn't matter whether it's sanctification. Doesn't matter whether it's deliverance. Doesn't matter whether it's the infilling of the Holy Spirit. If you'll call on your heavenly Joshua, it guarantees the power and the presence of the Holy Spirit. Just like it guaranteed the help of the Lord and how He miraculously used, amen, the elements of the earth to defeat the enemies of Gibeon. And then it says in verse 12, Then spoke Joshua to the Lord in the day when the Lord delivered up the Amorites before the children of Israel. And he, Joshua, said in the sight of Israel, Son, stand thou still upon Gibeon, and thou moon in the valley of Ajalon. And the sun stood still, and the moon stayed. I said, the sun stood still, and the moon stayed until the people had avenged themselves upon their enemies. The sun literally stood still. What do you mean? God stopped the turning of the earth. And the sun stood still for one, the earth stood still for one whole day. Hallelujah. Sun never moved. Moon never moved. Amen. Could you imagine at 10 o'clock, amen, or let's say 9 o'clock in the summer when the sun's setting and all of a sudden, the earth just stops. 10 o'clock, sun's still there. 11 o'clock, sun's still there. Midnight, sun's still there. 1 o'clock in the morning, sun's still there. 2 o'clock. I know people would say, well, Brother Brad, that's just a fairy tale. There's no way in science that that could ever happen. Well, let me tell you this. It is said that this is confirmed by state documents of Egypt, of China, and Mexico, which recorded this double day. We have 3 to 4 different countries that were still around back then that recorded this. When this had happened. It happened. I said it happened. This is a greater miracle than the opening of the Red Sea. The earth standing still and the sun shining for a whole day. And the reason Joshua asked for this, because they needed daylight to see so they could defeat the enemy. Amen. Some of you aren't getting this yet. When you call on the name of the Lord, and it guarantees the help of the Holy Spirit, amen, God commands the light, just like He did for the physical earth, to shine in your heart, and it stays there, amen. And when that light shines in your heart, guess what? Darkness flees. I said, darkness flees. I said, darkness flees. Amen. In John, 2 Corinthians 4:6, for God who commanded the light to shine out of darkness has shined in our hearts to give the light of the knowledge of the glory of God in the face of Jesus Christ. Amen. When you have strongholds and bondages in your life and in your heart, you call on the name of the Lord. It guarantees the help of the Holy Spirit. And God commands the light, who is Jesus Christ, to shine in your heart. And that darkness and that bondage has to flee. Oh, praise God, church. I said, praise God. Light always, if you want to look this up in science, look it up in science. Whenever light shines, darkness flees. Yes, amen. Light doesn't flee when darkness comes. It's the opposite. Only light can take away darkness. The only time darkness has come back, when light is withdrawn. Yes. When light is withdrawn, then darkness comes. But darkness can't overtake light. Right. It's just scientifically impossible. Turn out all the lights in here and turn on a flashlight. The darkness can't overtake the light. If I turned out the lights and turned on a flashlight, if it would work. Amen. The darkness can't overtake it. The minute the flashlight comes on or the light comes on, darkness flees. But the only way darkness can overtake the light is if light is withdrawn. And the only way light can be withdrawn is if you take your faith out of Christ. And then light is withdrawn and darkness will overtake. Amen. It's good revelation. Amen. God will command the light to shine in those dark spots where those strongholds are in your heart. Amen. And it'll stay still right there as long as you evidence faith and fight the good fight of faith. God will command the light, amen, to shine in that darkened heart. And that darkness will retract. It will have to flee. That bondage will have to go so you can have victory over it. Hallelujah. And what do I have to do, Brother Brad, to do that? All you got to do is call on your heavenly Joshua. Allow the power and the presence of the Holy Spirit to help you. Amen. Which guarantees His help. Hallelujah. And God will command the light, who is Christ Jesus, to shine in our hearts, and darkness will flee, and you will have victory over sin as long as you fight the good fight of faith, because He's paid for it already. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. And it says in verse 13, and the sun stood still. Amen. Just as the sun, S-U-N, stood still for Joshua here in the Bible, the sun, S-O-N, will stand still in your heart and shine in your heart and take away the darkness, hallelujah, and give you victory over sin, give you victory over flesh, and give you victory over the powers of darkness. Because whenever light goes, amen, whenever light shines, darkness has to flee. It's scientifically proven. Amen. That's why we got street lights out on the streets. Amen. When it's dark. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. We have to see. Amen. That's why we have lights on the car so we can see. Darkness has to retreat. It works the same way in the spiritual sense. When you call on the name of the Lord in name of Jesus, it guarantees the help of the Holy Spirit, and He commands light to shine in your walk, in your life, and in your heart, and darkness has to flee. And not only will it won't just shine for 5 minutes. It won't just shine for an hour. It'll stay and continue to shine as long as you evidence faith in His Son, Christ Jesus, and what He has done. It'll stand still. It'll stay there. Doesn't matter whether it's 11 o'clock. Doesn't matter whether it's midnight. Doesn't matter whether it's 2 in the morning. That light will stay in your heart and shine. And the powers of darkness have no choice but to flee. Wherever Christ is, darkness flees. Wherever the light is, the darkness has to flee. Amen. Satan wants no part of Christ. I know people always think that the devil and Jesus are arguing and wrestling and fighting and this and that and talking like Hollywood always says. No. The minute Jesus steps into the room, Satan says, I'm out of here. Hallelujah. He looks at Jesus, I have nothing to say to you. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. We see that in the Bible, amen. When Jesus would just come up to the man who was possessed, the first words out of the mouth of those demons, please don't send us into the abyss. Let us go into the swine. Just let us get out of here. Hallelujah. There was no arguing. There was no debate. The minute the light showed up, darkness said, we're out of here. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. And that sun, S-O-N, spiritually speaking, will stand still in your heart and life as long as you just fight the good fight of faith, believing in what He's already done at Calvary. Just like the sun here for Joshua, S-U-N, stood still for Gibeon so they could have victory. Amen. Oh, isn't that a wonderful promise? Amen. That is the greatest miracle. That was bigger than the opening of the Red Sea. Amen. Because why is that? Think about this. Look at this. Amen. Hallelujah. Oh, I'm excited, church. Verse 14. It says, and there was no day like that before it or after it. There was many times, amen, that the River Jordan opened up and parted. Amen. It parted for the Red Sea for Moses. the miracle of the parting of Jordan for Joshua. So it happened more than once. But we only see this here in Scripture happening once, where the sun stood still, and it never stood still before it or after it ever again. What do you say? I'm saying this is the greatest miracle that could ever happen. And spiritually speaking, it's the greatest miracle that could ever happen to the believer when they call upon the name of the Lord, get the guaranteed help of the Holy Spirit, and God commands the light to shine in your darkened heart and take away that darkness and body. It's the greatest miracle, church. There's nothing ever like it before it, and there'll be nothing like it after it. Hallelujah. Praise God. The greatest miracle, salvation, and the believer having victory over sin. I said the greatest miracles are the sinner getting saved when God commands the light to shine in their heart and gives them a new heart, amen, and an upright spirit. And it's the greatest miracle for the believer who's struggling with sin and darkness in their heart and life and walk, and God once again commands the light to stand still in their heart. It's the greatest miracle, and there's nothing ever like it before or after it in your walk and in your life. Nothing greater. No riches in the earth can ever top that. Amen. No riches can ever top that. I'll even say this, no physical healing can ever top that either. The greatest miracle is the sinner getting saved and the believer walking in victory. There's nothing like it before it, and there'll be nothing like it ever after it. Amen. Having victory over sin. Oh, praise God. There's nothing like it. Amen. No other miracle greater than that. Hallelujah. That's why the preaching of the word, amen, whether it be an apostle, prophet, evangelist, pastor, teacher, amen. That's why those are the highest ranking callings in the army of God. Because they tell the good news of how to have victory over sin and how the sinner can get saved. And there's nothing greater than that. Nothing this world hath offers greater than that. Nothing that Satan tempts you with is greater than that. Nothing. Nothing compares to it. Amen. Just as the sun, S-U-N, stood still for Joshua. There is nothing greater than, amen. Nothing in the Bible greater than that. Amen. Miracle-wise. Does that make sense tonight? Hallelujah. There's more meat to this than you thought. You just thought I was going to talk a few minutes about how the sun stood still and bada bing, bada boom, we're done. Amen. But there's such great revelation and meat in this. Think of that. There is nothing greater than the sinner getting saved and making it into heaven. And there's nothing greater than the believer, oh praise God, walking in victory over sin. Hallelujah. And Joshua and the Gibeon army and the Israelite army, they gave victory over them. Gave victory over these Amorite kings. Amen. And when he gives you victory, he gives you the victory. Amen. Look at this in Hallelujah. Verse 24. Amen. And it came to pass, when they brought out those kings unto Joshua, that Joshua called for all the men of Israel, and said unto the captains of the men of war, which went with him, come near, put your feet upon the necks of these kings. And they came near and put their feet upon the necks of them. Amen. Symbolizing and showing, amen, this isn't just a temporary victory, but this is a permanent victory. Put your foot on the neck of these kings, Amen. And that's what the Lord wants you to do. Amen. Fight the good fight of faith. Amen. And the Holy Spirit will guarantee you the help and the victory. And all you have to do is take your foot and put it on the neck of sin and on the powers of darkness. Hallelujah. Because you have victory. I said you have total and complete victory. Sin shall not have dominion over you. I said, sin shall not have dominion over you. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. If the smoker would call out to the Lord, if the alcoholic would call out to the Lord, if the drug addict would call out to the Lord, if the homosexual would call out to the Lord, if the rapist would call out to the Lord. See, this is the great thing about Calvary. Amen. For God so loved the world. I know when we hear that, we think, oh, they shouldn't be saved. But you know what? God loved them all. I said, God loved them all. Amen. He loved you. I said, He loved you. I said, He loved you. Hallelujah. You may be thinking, well, I'm not that bad, okay? You better be careful. You might find yourself in the same boat with Job. Amen. And you'll come back and say, Brother Brad, you was right. Amen. So you just better say amen now. Hallelujah. I said hallelujah. He'll give you total and complete victory over sin. Now that doesn't mean we'll be sinless. We will make mistakes. Amen. We will get in the flesh at times because we're human. Amen. While the sin nature goes dormant, it's not eradicated yet. Well, why would the Lord leave it there? He leaves it there to keep us humble. Amen. So that we continually trust in Him. Amen. Because the minute we get arrogant, the minute we get prideful, the minute we think we can do it, guess what? That old sin nature roars back up and start taking over again. Amen. Because guess what? We're pulling our faith out of Christ. Light is withdrawing and darkness is coming back again. But the minute we call upon the name of the Lord, amen, the Holy Spirit goes to work and He commands the light to start shining and pushing back those powers of darkness and bondages of sin once again. And He will stay there. He'll stand still and give you the total and complete victory. For if we be planted together in the likeness of His death, we shall also have the likeness of His resurrection, and we can have the first fruits. Victory over sin. Victory over the flesh. Victory over the powers of darkness. And we see here in verse 24 that it's a total and complete victory by the symbolization here of the men of war putting their feet upon the necks. Amen. Of the kings of the Amorites. Hallelujah. See, you don't have to fight against Satan. You don't fight against Satan. When the powers of darkness come against you, you resist the devil. You submit to God. What's submitting to God? You call upon the name of the Lord. Amen. The Holy Spirit and grace starts going to work. Amen. He fights the battle for you. Next thing you know, the devil's on the floor, on his belly. And Jesus says, come over here. Step on his neck. Hallelujah. He says, see, he can't do nothing to you. Fear not. Amen. If you're trusting in me, I got him under my boot. Hallelujah. I said, hallelujah. Praise the Lord. And Joshua said unto them, fear not, nor be dismayed. Be strong and of good courage. For thus shall the Lord do to all your enemies against whom you fight. Amen. Every single enemy that comes against you, whether it's principalities, whether it's powers, whether it's wickedness in high places, whether it's Satan himself, doesn't matter. The Lord will do the same thing to all of them. Amen. Just resist the devil, meaning don't try to fight him. The minute you get in the ring with the devil, amen, you're done. Amen. The minute you get in the ring with the devil, you're done. I don't care what you try to do. Amen. I know they say Bruce Lee, probably one of the greatest martial art fighters, amen, and whoever lived. And it was said that, and we learned this when we went down to camp meeting in 09, that Bruce Lee, if he would get defeated, he would take that other person who defeated him, take their martial arts, amen, learn it, and redo something that would beat it. And he was considered one of the greatest martial art fighters, amen, but he was an atheist. And right now, if he didn't accept Christ, I don't know his heart, but if he didn't accept Christ, he's in hell right now. And those martial arts ain't doing him any good. It's not doing him any good. You ain't stronger than Satan. You can't take him on. Amen. The only thing you can do is resist the devil. Submit yourself unto God. Call upon the name of the Lord in the name of Jesus, who guarantees the help of the Holy Spirit. And guess what? The Holy Spirit and Jesus are stronger men than the strong man. Amen. I said the Lord is a stronger man than the strong man. I believe Jesus used that parable, amen, when he said a stronger man came in and bound up the strong man. Amen. So resist the devil. You want to have victory? I'll tell you how to have victory. Resist the devil. Don't fight him on your own. Don't try to use your intellect. Don't try to use your self-helps. Don't try to use self. Don't try to use life coaches. But resist the devil. Put your faith in the Lord. And say, I know he'll give me victory because he's won it at Calvary. It's that simple. And call upon his name. And he's faithful to answer. And just fight the good fight of faith on a daily basis. Deny yourself. Take up your cross. And follow him. Which guarantees the help of the Holy Spirit. Amen. And you can have an unlimited help of the Holy Spirit. Just as the Gibeons got the help of the power of God with the hailstone. Oh my. Holy Spirit will do a lot more than just throw down hailstone, amen. He's all powerful, amen. And he'll command the light to shine in that darkened part of your heart. And when the light shines, who is Christ Jesus, amen, darkness flees. And just as darkness flees, it says, resist the devil, submit unto God, and the devil will flee, amen. And that sin will flee. Those powers of darkness will flee. That darkness will flee. The devil will flee. Amen. And you can put your foot by faith on the neck of him. Amen. Meaning you can have complete, total victory where that does not dominate you anymore. It doesn't run your whole life anymore. Amen. But holiness, righteousness, amen, Christ-likeness comes out because the light is shining. Amen. And that light will stay. The sun will stand still. I said the sun will stand still. And there'll be nothing ever like it. Before in your life or after in your life. Let that sink into your hearts tonight. Having complete, total victory over sin. I know sin is pleasurable, but it's only for a season. I said I know sin is pleasurable, but it's only for a season. Amen. Fornication is pleasurable. It is. Amen. We're human. Now, we can all say that. Amen. But when it's outside of marriage, it's only pleasurable for a season. Amen. Alcohol, it's pleasurable for a season. Amen. See, Satan always tries to imitate God by using bondages and temptations and lust to try to give you the effect of what the Holy Spirit can give you. And that's what Satan does. That's what alcohol does. That's what smoking does. That's what fornication does. That's what lusts do. Think about it. Satan tries to tempt you away by giving you worldly lusts and pleasures, which will only last for a season. He's trying to keep you away from God and the joy you can have in your heart. That's what he's doing. Amen. And Satan is doing it to keep you away from God and to drag you farther into sin. And the minute you want to get out, then you can't, because then you're stuck. Amen. Think about it. That's what alcohol does. That's what smoking does. That's what fornication does. Amen. That's what crimes do. They're pleasurable for a while. How's a crime pleasurable? Because it gives you adrenaline rush. The excitement of getting caught. But it's only for a season, because then the consequences come in. Amen. Alcohol, smoking, cancer. Amen. fornication, transmitted diseases. Amen. Cigarettes, cancer, emphysema. It's pleasurable for a season. Why would you do that when you can call upon the name of the Lord and have the joy of the Holy Spirit with no consequences attached and have life and life more abundantly? The sun will stand still and it can give you a joy that will never end. Amen. It can give you a peace that will never end. Amen. It can give you things that will never end. He will command the sun to stand still in your heart. Think of it. The sun. S-O-N. Sun. Just as he did the physical sun, S-U-N, for Joshua. He will command the sun, S-O-N, to stand still in your heart. And darkness will flee and it'll give you a joy, a peace, and a rest that the things of the world could never give you. Amen. And that's what the Lord wants to do tonight, whether it's here or on camera. He wants the sun to stand still, amen, in your heart and in your life and set you free and give you something you've never had before. Victory. Freedom. Liberty. Joy. Peace. And the greatest thing is it's paid for. You don't have to work for it. It's paid for. Amen. He can give you something that the devil can only give you that's temporary. Amen. He can give you victory. He can give you joy, peace. The only thing Satan and darkness can give you is a temporary joy, a temporary happiness that will fade away. Amen. See, Satan is smart. He knows what he's doing. He's not doing it for your excitement. He's doing it to kill you. He literally wants to kill you. If he could, he would kill you right now without even thinking about it. We see this in the book of Job. In the book of Job, amen, Job's family did not want to serve God. It says his sons and his daughters mocked God. That's in Job chapter 1. They mocked God, and their father, Job, was praying for him every day and giving up offerings and saying, Lord, please don't do anything to my family. And when the conversation came about between Satan and the Lord, Satan asked, give me power over Job and everything he has. And the Lord said, okay, you can have power over Job, you just can't touch him. And you know what Satan did? Satan wiped out his whole family without even thinking about it. It doesn't say that Satan thought about it. He just wiped it out because the Lord opened the door for him to do whatever he wanted to Job, except for Job's physical body. He took his wealth, took his family, took his sons, took his daughters, took everything. That's what Satan wants to do to you. He's tempting you and he's lying to you, telling you that alcohol is pleasurable, fornication is pleasurable, cigarettes are pleasurable, homosexuality is pleasurable. He's lying to you. I'm telling you, he's lying to you. He does not have your best interests in heart. He's tempting you little by little by little, dragging you into sin so he can kill you. And what he does is, he gives you, we'll just take alcohol for example. He gives you a little, tempts you with alcohol. You get a buzz. Well, guess what? Your body gets a tolerance to it. Satan says, up it up a little. You up it up a little. Up it up a little. Until you have liver cancer. Or you can take cigarettes. Or you can take fornication. Amen. I'll take fornication. He'll tell you it's okay to have sex outside marriage. You love her, go ahead. Okay, you do it. And then your flesh lusts for something else. Well, I'm getting bored of this one. Better go to someone else. Amen. And you bounce to bed, to bed, to bed, to bed, to bed. Amen. And you go deeper into sin, just like I taught this morning. Oh, well, girls aren't getting it anymore, so I guess I'll try guys. And then you bounce to bed, to bed, to bed, and it just gets farther and farther and farther until you have AIDS or you have a disease. Because that's what Satan wants. He wants to kill you off. Amen. You can take any sin you want. That's what Satan's intentions is. It's like taking, say this was a bottle of poison. Amen. and you take a bull. Just like in the story with the poison in the pottage. Amen. He puts a little in and he says, eat. Puts a little in, and he says, eat. And you say, that's spicy. And then you just continually eat it. And it says, well, it doesn't have that kick anymore. Pours a little more in. Says, now eat. That's what Satan's doing. Amen. And the Lord wants you to be free from that. Amen. And what will he do? He will make the sun, S-O-N, stand still in your heart and make that darkness flee. And all there's only one thing you have to do. Amen. Call upon the name of the Lord. The Holy Spirit will go to work and just fight the good fight of faith and believe that what Jesus did at Calvary, he'll give you the victory. And guess what? God will command the sun, S-O-N, to stand still in your heart, and that darkness will flee, and he will give you a permanent victory over whatever you're struggling with. Amen. And we know it will be a complete victory because we see the indication of Joshua stepping on the necks of the kings. And that's what the Lord wants you to do to Satan and the powers of darkness and sin. Amen. He wants the sun to stand still in your heart and you to have complete victory over that, whatever it is you're struggling with, and be able to spiritually step on the neck of sin where it does not have dominion over you anymore, whatever the problem may be. Amen. And again, as I close, it's simple. You don't have to be part of a certain denomination. You don't have to do certain works. You don't have to try to earn merit it. All you have to do is by faith call upon the name of the Lord, who is Jesus Christ, and God the Holy Ghost will go to work. And if you'll evidence faith on a daily basis in what Christ has done at the cross, amen, he will command the sun, S-O-N, to stand still in your heart. How do you know it's the cross? Because look here, amen. You don't have to turn to it. I'll just read the final verse. And he said, after they stepped on the neck here in verse 26, it says, and afterward Joshua smote them and slew them and hanged them on 5 trees. And they were hanging upon the trees until the evening. And it came to pass at the time of the going down of the sun, S-U-N, that Joshua commanded, and they took them down off the trees and cast them into the cave wherein they had been hid, and laid great stones in the cave's mouth, which remain until this very day. We see in these last 2 verses why we have victory. This is how Christ defeated sin. Amen. By it being crucified, amen, on the cross, and those sins then taken and put into the tomb, and the stone rolled over the cave to never bother you ever again. Amen. Complete and total victory. Amen. That's what Christ did for you. He hung on the cross and defeated all the powers of darkness and every sin that you would ever deal with. He defeated it there, represented by the 5 kings being hanged on the tree and then put in the cave. Your sins, amen, everything you done was taken care of at the cross. Amen. And the Lord took them, put them in the tomb, rolled the stone, never be remembered ever again. That's grace. Amen. If you notice, it says in there 5 trees. 5 means grace. That's grace. Amen. Total and complete victory. And the sun stood still. Would you stand? As I close in prayer tonight, I implore any of you, I don't know what you're struggling with, I don't know what's in your heart, I don't know what you're going through, whether it be here on camera. I'm not God. I'm not. I just preach what God tells me to preach, and that's it. Amen. But the Lord is telling you tonight, you can have complete and total victory over sin. If by faith you will call upon the name of the Lord, the Holy Spirit will go to work, the sun, S-O-N, will stand still in your heart, darkness will flee, those bondages will be destroyed and broken because Christ already took them to the cross and he put them in the tomb. He rolled the stone in front of the tomb so it'd be never to be remembered ever again. And all you have to do is by faith, amen, believe that's taken care of, what he already done, and fight the good fight of faith, amen. And the sun will stand still in your heart and in your life. And there'll be a day where you have total and complete victory over whatever you're struggling with. Amen? Amen. Amen. Heavenly Father, Lord, I've done my best to minister your word. Father, I ask in the name of Jesus that you take this to hearts, Lord. Let them place your faith in you and what you've done at the cross, Lord. And let that bondage or sin be put in the tomb, never to be remembered ever again, Lord. And let them be able by faith to step on the neck of sin and on Satan, Lord. And give them complete and total victory as they evidence faith in you and take up their cross daily and follow you. And Lord, we believe it by faith and call it done. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. God.